नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयं भजेत्। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 10 चैप्टर 29 वर्स नंबर 4। निसंग गीतं तदनंग वर्धनं ब्रजस्त्रिया कृष्ण गृहीत मानसा आजगमुरन्योन्यम अलक्षितोद्यम क्षेत्र कांतो जव लोल कुंडला। आफ्टर हियरिंग द flute of Krishna, Nisamna Gitam, and this song which came out from the flute, as we read in the previous verse, where it said that Jagau Kalam Vamadrisham Manoharam, that it had a special sense of attracting the beloved gopis. So therefore it said Tadananga Vardhanam, it increased there prema. And Vrajastriya, that is the subject of the verse, Krishna Grihita Manasa. So their minds were captivated by Krishna. So they came where Krishna was, Ajagmu, Anyonyam Alakshita Udyama, but they came without telling each other secretly. And where did they go? Sayatra Kantaha, where their beloved Krishna was. And Javlola Kundala, their earrings were moving briskly, fast, in a hurry. So we studied Sanatana Goswami's commentary, right? And did we study Jiva Goswami also? So now it is Vishnu Chakruti, right? Okay, so this is Sararth Darshini by Sri Vishnu Chakruti. So he says, Kalagita Sutra Gumphita Panchalika Ivata Krishnantikam Ayata Tya. So he is making like a, what you call, allegory, that just like when there is a panchalika, panchalika means a puppet, and puppet is moved by the threads, right? Dances with the thread. So gopis were like the panchalika, they were like the puppets. How? Kalagita Sutra Gumphita, as if they were tied to the thread of that love song which Krishna played by his flute. And therefore, Ta Krishna Antikam Ayata, they came near Krishna. So to say this, Sri Sukadeva Goswami speaks this verse, beginning with Nisamya Gitam Tad Anandavadam. So Tad Gitam, so Tad Gitam means that song. So which song? Which was mentioned in the previous verse, Jagau Kalam Vamadrisham Manoharam. So hearing that song, Manoharamapi Manoja Vardhanam. So in the previous sloka it was said that the song is Manohara, that it steals away the mind. And that's what Manohara means. Although we translate the word Manohara generally as beautiful. Right? This is how you will see the meaning in the dictionary. The word Manohara is beautiful, attractive, but literally it means that which steals away your mind, because that's what beauty is. It captures the mind. So he says that although that song was Manohara, it captured their mind, at the same time it was doing something more. So Manoja Vardhanam. So mind is the place where the Manoja or love appears. So Cupid is also called Manoja. So the song was Manohara, and in the mind is Manoja. That's where it takes birth. Manoja means which takes birth in the mind. That's where the love manifests, right? Love does not manifest in some finger or some other, right? Comes in the mind, therefore it is called Manoja. So, Manoja Vardhanam. And it was not that Manoj was appearing there, but Manoj was increasing. Means it was already there, and then it started growing. So that's what made them move. Otherwise, the love was already there, there was no need for them to take any action. But now it was beyond their limit to hold it. They have to take action. And sometimes, like you are hungry, so you can tolerate. But sometimes the hunger goes beyond tolerance. Then you cannot just sit. You go crazy if you don't get food. Then you run here and there, where you can even steal. You don't get it, right? So that's the situation. The love was already there, but now the love became very intense. That is the meaning of Vardhanam. So they cannot contain it in themselves. They have to take an action. So therefore they ran towards Krishna. Kincha Krishna hi Venugitakhyam Mahachauram Braje Prashitvan. So Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur has his own way of seeing things. So he says that this song which Krishna plays on the flute, this song is a big thief. Not only Chora, but Mahachora. Krishna is a thief, he is called Chora, Makhan Chora. But the song which he played with his flute, that is Mahachora. It's a big thief. The king of the thieves. So Krishna has sent the thief to Vraj. You see, at night thieves come out. Night is the time when thieves become active. So when Krishna saw the moon appearing in the eastern direction, then he said, okay, now it is the time for thieves to be active. In the daytime, thieves sleep, and night time is when they make their daily wages. So, he sent the thief at night. And where do you go at night? To the village, to steal, where people are living. So therefore he says that Venu, the name of the thief is Venu Gita. That is the name. So he says, Venu Gita Akhyam Mahacharam Braje Prashitvan. So there's some in India, there are people who are like the leader of thieves. They don't go themselves to steal. They have people working under them and they tell them, okay, now you go there, you go there. Recently I was reading in news that there was one guy, he collected some millions of dollars from ATM by stealing people's codes, hacking. And he had his people all over the world stealing for him. So he will take his cut and they will take their cut. But finally he was caught. He collected, I don't know, a few hundred millions. They will figure out where are the people going, which ATM has the maximum money. So he will go and grab that. And it went on for 2-3 years. Finally they caught him. So he was not stealing himself. He was orchestrating it from behind. And his men were going around to the ATMs at night and pulling out all the money. In the morning they see that everything is empty. So this is what Krishna is doing. He says he sent this Venu Gita, the big thief, to the Vraj. Tena cha vrajastrinam niskapatena karna dwarena antakaran koshagaram praveshya. So generally what happens is that if you have your treasury you keep it locked. But there are some people who never lock their door, like Acharya Jagdish. So you're free for all, anybody can enter, human beings, monkeys, dogs. Right?
Yes.
So gopis were also doing that because there was no such theft going on in Vraja. So they have kept their treasury with open doors. And the doors are the ears. And the treasury is in the heart. So the thief, in the form of the song, he entered through the ears into the heart of the gopis. Because the door was open. So there was no obstruction. He just went straight for the kill. So Karna Dwarena Antakaran Koshagaram Pravishya. So he entered into the Koshagar in the treasury. And Manasasaha Dharya Lajja Bhaya Viveka Deen Mahadhanan Aprahitya. So he stole. And what all he stole? Many things. Not just one thing. So first is that he stole the mind. Means he did not steal just little bit of money. He took the whole box. Because mind is that which keeps the wealth in it. So he stole the mind, and along with the mind, he stole whatever is contained in it. So what is there in the mind? Lajja, like modesty, bhaya, fear, viveka, discrimination. So all this which was inside the box of mind, he took it away. So now the gopis, they don't have the mind. Therefore the verse said, Krishna grihita manasa. Right? That the gopis whose mind was stolen by Krishna, and along with the mind they had no fear to leave the home at night. Who wants to go at night in the forest? Especially in the olden days, there were a lot of ferocious animals. And also no lajja, modesty of the family people, what they are going to say, where is he going? And no viveka, no thinking. So if you want to perform bhakti, then this kind of viveka, what will happen to me in old age? Well, who will take care of me? Right? People think like that. So you have to give up this kind of viveka. If you want to use your viveka like that, you will never come to spiritual life. Anybody who comes to spiritual life, although we say that you have to use your viveka, right? But actually when you come to spiritual life, you drop your viveka. Isn't it? It is the parents or the friends or the other people who will tell you, what are you doing? Are you crazy? Why are you giving up your job? Right? You have a nice job. And how will you maintain yourself?
What will you do in your old age?
Yeah, old age is another problem. And no social security.
Medical insurance. Yeah.
If you fall sick, who will take care of you and in the ashram?
Your student debt.
So all this viveka is lost. So this is the meaning of this sloka, that if you have to come to Krishna, then you have to give up this lajja, modesty. What others will say? Look, this guy shaved his head. Shaving his head and putting this mud on his face and wearing bad shit. So what's wrong with him? Right? So you have to actually give up this kind of thing if you want to come to spiritual life. Because everybody will actually make fun of you. And you have to give up the fear, what will happen to me? Who will take care of me? Because your family members, they are all going to drop you. And all this viveka. So this is what happens when somebody hears Krishna's flute. This is what Rupa Goswami was saying in that verse, don't go to Kesi Ghat.
That was about darshan.
And this fellow is standing there with three men.
Vangshi, playing the flute.
So, Mahadhanani Aparitya. So, these are considered as the wealth in the material world. Means if you want to remain sticking to the material world, this is your wealth. You have to have fear. If you want to become fearless, then come to Abhaycharan. Krishna is called Abhaycharan. So, jhatiti eva aniya Krishna dattani. So therefore what this song did, that he grabbed these things from the treasury of the gopis, treasury house, took the box which had all these jewels and ran away and gave it to Krishna. But Krishna is the boss, you know, he's waiting. So now what happens if a thief enters in your house and you see him stealing, what do? You chase him. So that's what Gopis are doing. That's why they came to Krishna. They were chasing him. I remember once when he used to work in the Goshala. So one day we were all there. I was there, and especially this, what is his name?
Pramiti?
No, the German devotee.
Astarata.
Bhakti is ex-husband.
Gaurachandra.
So Gaurachandra was there, Bhakti Devi, we were all working, and it was evening time. And some construction work was going in the Goshala. And there was a room inside where we used to change our cloth and put on another cloth to work in the Goshala. So, you know, whatever you have, it's lying there. If you have money, you leave it there. So one of the worker went and he took Gaurachandra's wallet. And it so happened that Gaurachandra went inside to drink water and he saw him. And this guy ran. And then Gaurachandra is running behind him. Thief, thief, thief. I still remember this. And this fellow is running fast. And he tried to disappear, but where can he disappear in the Gaurachandra? So he ran into the dark corner. And then we caught him. So this is what gopis were doing, that they saw the thief stealing and then they are chasing him. But the thief ran faster than them, that's the thing. Gopis were not good at running. So that's why Javalola Kundala, that's why the rings were shaking. So Krishnaena Grihitani Manasani Manansi Cha Manasani Manasambandhini Dhriti Smriti Vivek Lajja Bhiti Matyadini Asamta. So Krishnaena Grihita Manasa. So Manasa is an interesting word. It did not say Krishnaena Grihita Manasa. It says Krishnaena Grihita Manasa. So Manasa means that which belongs to Manas. Right? Manas is the mind. And then you have to apply anpratyaya on that. Then it becomes manasa, which means that which belongs to the mind. So that's why Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur is writing it like this. Krishnaena grihita manasa. You see how deeply he is thinking? Everybody is writing that their minds were stolen by Krishna. But he's saying, no, not the mind, but what was inside the mind. Because it is grihita manasa. Of course, anpratya can also be applied in the swartha, manasa, you can also say that, but he's taking it in a different sense. So he says, manasani, manansi cha, manasani. So not only the mind, but also what is in the mind. Manasambandhini, and what is that? Dhriti, smriti, viveka, lajja, bhiti, matyadini, asanta. So, as he said earlier, so their fortitude, their memory, that's why they could not remember that where are we, it is in night time, now our family people are there, none of these things, no concern for any of this. So you run This is how you have to come to spiritual life. If your strings are attached, then you have not come to spiritual life. People come to spiritual life externally, but internally they remain wherever they were before. So this is the way to come to spiritual life. You have to come to spiritual life, then you have to cut all your knots completely. Then you come to Krishna. So no need to bring your backpack. Can just come by yourself. So therefore he says that all their fortitude, their memory, their vivek, their discriminating faculty, their modesty, fear, mati, their mind, all this yasanta. Ajagmu, and they came to Krishna. Why they came to Krishna? He explains. Mahachor Chakravarti Naha Krishna Tani Swashva Dhanani Prathitum Eveti Bhava. So because Krishna is the Mahachor Chakravarti. In the olden days there used to be kings, and above kings there used to be an emperor. He was called Chakravarti Samrat. So Chakravarti means that there are many kings around him over whom he rules. Because the idea was that sometimes kings also become unruly. They are the rulers, but they also should be disciplined. Otherwise they can do whatever they feel like doing. They have absolute power. So a great king who was very pious, religious, rooted in dharma, he would control them. Like Yudhishthira Maharaj, he did Rajasuya Yajna. So that is the purpose of doing Rajasuya Yajna. The purpose is not just to expand your kingdom, because these kings still remain kings. He did not dethrone them. That's why they all came when he did the Rajasuya Yajna, they came. No, they remain king, but he is the one who is overseeing them. So just like you have court, lower court, then high court, and then you have supreme court. So sometimes the lower courts, they can give wrong decisions, they can become influenced, they take bribes, all these things happen. And Supreme Court is the final authority, which is expected to be more judicious and clean and no bribery. So like that, there is also Mahachor Chakravarti, Krishna. There are small thieves, and then there is a big one on top of them who is taking his cut from the lower ones. So they came to him because all the booty came there. So they came to beg him that please return our wealth back, these guys have stolen. So tadevam manye tam mahachoram dhartum vyagranam anyonyam na lakshitam. So I think like this, that when this mahachor, which is the song of the flute, came and stole, then they ran behind. And that's why it is said the anyonya lakshita udyama, that they did not inform anybody. Because if you have a thief in your house and you are running, you are not going to inform the neighbor that come, you also come. You have no time for that. So that means if you want to come to spiritual life, then don't make an assembly and declare, look, I'm going to join this. Are you also coming? No, forget it. Don't try that. You do that, you will also not come. You have to just run without telling anybody. Just escape. Right? Like Raghunath Das Goswami, how he escaped from the house. He went to do puja at his guru's temple. But instead of going to the temple, he ran to the forest. And he ran, how many, 18 days or something? 12 days he was just running. Marathon. Right? Big marathon. Because he was so worried that he can get caught. His father was a rich guy, he would send people to catch him. So he did not go through the main route. He was running through the forest so that nobody sees him. And he ran till he reaches Jagannath Puri. Then he said, okay, now I can take some Mahaprasad. So this is the meaning of Anyanya Lakshita Udyam. Tadeva Manye Tam Mahacharam Dhartum Vyagranam. So because they wanted to catch the thief, therefore they are Vyagra. Vyagra means very agitated, aggressive. They were not in a peaceful mind. And there was no time to consult or things like that. Anyanyam na lakshita udyamo yasamta. So therefore their effort was not seen by anyone else. They ran so quickly that nobody even realized that they have run away. They just shoot out from the house. Nobody thought that somebody is, regularly everybody is in the house and suddenly one person runs away. You don't know what happened. So, chaurasya pashat pashat eva ajagam. So, therefore, they followed the footsteps. So, the idea is that as soon as the song entered into their ears, immediately they left. There was no time to think, deliberate, whose flute is this, whose song is it, what is the meaning behind it, what is the purpose, none of this kind of thinking. As soon as the sign entered, then immediately they ran, simultaneously. Sabdhyaya, as Bhagavatam says, that Krishna enters the heart, sabdhyaya, tatakshanaya, right?
Shanat.
So like that, immediately.
Tatakshanat.
Sabdhyaya hridaya vruddhyate atra kritihi, shushrushuhi tatakshanat. Immediate action. So just in the same way, as Krishna comes in the heart, gopis ran like that. Kwa, where did they go? Which place? Sa kanto yatra. Where that kanta, their lover, Krishna, he was standing. Javena vegena lolani kundalani kundala uplakshitani kankana kinkini adini api yasham ta. So they were running so fast that their earrings were dangling. And this dangling of the earrings is also an uplakshana. Uplakshana means which is an indicative of something else. That it is not only the earrings were dangling, but also their kinkini, what they have tied on their girdle, their anklets, bracelets, everything was shaking. Because everybody was joyous. All these ornaments were so happy, right? They were dancing. That now our life has become fulfilled because Krishna would get a chance to see us. So that's why they were not just moving because they are running. They were also jumping themselves out of happiness. So tena saha tasam bahishkaran grihasthitani dhanani alpamulyatva buddhya chaurena tena napahitani iti bhava. So he says that the meaning, the implied meaning that the earrings were dangling is that this thief who came, he did not bother about the earrings. Because he wanted only that real wealth of the heart. So he went. So this external wealth he did not take. Means all these bracelets and anklets and necklace and earrings, all the gopis were wearing a lot of ornaments. This he did not steal. Otherwise he would have also stolen those things. Many times thieves do that, you know, they snatch the chain or some other ornament of a woman. So he did not steal. He says these are worthless things. If you want to steal, steal the heart. And if the heart is stolen, then all these ornaments will come automatically. You don't have to steal them because they will come with that person. So that's what he did. He is a smart thief. He is not stealing useless things. So this is what you say is the meaning of this. So he says, Chaurena Tena Naapritam. So therefore these things were not stolen by a thief. So this is a very nice comment by Vishnath Chakravarti Thakur. And how appropriately it fits each word of the verse. Why it is they were not seen by each other, why the earrings are dangling. It is Krishna Grihit Manasa. So nice. Okay, any question on this? Yes.
I sometimes have heard that that Krishna's mercy means also that he takes away your wealth.
Mm.
So is it then, in other places of the scripture, does it then also, I guess this statement I heard comes somehow from the scripture.
Yes, Shaham Anugranami Harisheta Dhananjana.
So is it there then also the wealth in the mind, or is there then...
Well, that is the real thing. Taking away external wealth, you will work hard to earn more wealth then, right?
Not me.
That's the question. But if it steals your mind itself, then that is the real wealth. Because wherever your mind is, that's where your wealth will be. Isn't it? If somebody steals your heart and you are a millionaire, then you will go to that person with your million bucks. Isn't it? Or you are going to leave the money back and go.
You write a prenuptial agreement.
Hmm?
You write a prenuptial agreement.
That means he has not stolen it. That doesn't happen if your heart is stolen. The agreements are now and nothing is stolen. There is nothing to steal anyway. I don't know, people have hearts. Anything else? So now he continues to explain Sukadeva Goswami. In the next three slokas, he explains the situation of the gopis. Here he just gave a general statement that they all ran to meet Krishna. But in the next three verses, he explains what they were doing and how they dropped everything. So this is also to show that this is how you have to come to Krishna. When Krishna says, Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam braja. So this is the meaning that you give up all dharmas and jump into the fire headlong. So he says, Duhantyo abhiyayu kachid doham hitva samutsakaha payodhishritta sanyavam manudvasya parayayuhu pariveshyante stadhitva payante shishunatha shushushante patin kashchid danantyo pashya bhojanam. So duhantyo abhiyayu kashchid. So some of them, they were milking the cows. Because they are cowherd people. So this is natural in the evening time, the milking of the cows. So some were milking cows, some were doing other things. So doham hitva abhiyayu. So they went to Krishna, giving up their milking. And samutsuka. Why? Because they were so eager to meet him. So not like the story that Narada Muni once went to Vaikuntha. He came on earth, he saw how people are suffering. Right? And then he went to Narayana and said, people are suffering, why don't you liberate them? So he said, okay, you go. I give you the power. So Narada was very happy, he said, he's going to liberate. So he made an announcement that anybody who wants to go to Vaikuntha with me, please come. Nobody came. Nobody even paid attention to him. So he thought that crowds will follow him. He was surprised that not even one person came. So you were shocked.
I was thinking like that this summer also. I was thinking, I've come from Vrindavan. People will be happy that someone has come from Vrindavan and will tell them. Nobody is interested.
Vrindavan will see. Nobody noticed him. Even after he shaved his beard. First he thought that they're scared of his beard. So he went up to that extent. So anyway, then Narada, you know the story that he tries very hard, but nobody really comes. Only finally he has to forcibly take one warm. So that's not the way. So gopis were samutsukaha. They are very eager, earnestly looking for this opportunity. And payodhishritya sanyavam anudyavasya parayai. And some of them have kept milk for heating and they did not care for it. They left. Hitva has to be applied everywhere. And sanyavam anudyasya hitva. And sanyav is what you call dalia, porridge in Hindi. In English, porridge, Sanskrit is called sanyav. So some were cooking that. So they left it, they did not even remove it. Anudvasya means not removing. They left. And parivashyante stad hitva, some were serving meals to their family members. So they left. Payante shishunatha, some were feeding milk to the babies. Shushrushante patin kaschit, some were doing service to their husbands. And ashnantyo pasya bhojanam, some were actually sat down to eating. They gave up that and they left. So Sridhar Swami's Bhavartitika. Sri Krishna Suchaka Shabda Shravanena Tata Pravana Chittanam Tatakshanam Eva Trivargika Karma Nivrittim Dyotyantya Eva Ardha Avashitam Karma Vihaya Yayus Tada. So he says that when they heard the sound of flute, which was indicative of Krishna, because they understood that this is Krishna's flute, so then their mind was completely fixed on him. Tat pravana chittanam. Tatakshanam eva, immediately, instantly, at the same moment, trayvargika karma nivrittim dyotanti. So Sridhar Swami's take on this verse is that it shows that how a person who comes to Krishna, he gives up the trivargik karma. Trivargika is dharma, artha and kama. Means all activities related to dharma, related to artha and kama are given up. So, tavad karmani kurvita nanirvidyate artha matkatha shramadava shraddhayavan jayate. Krishna says to Uddhava that you perform your duties, prescribed varnashram duties, only as long as you have not attained shraddha in hearing Krishna katha. Once you have attained Shraddha and Krishna Katha, then your adhikara for Varnashram duties, for your regular dharma, Varnashram dharma is over. Because then begins bhakti. When bhakti begins, you are outside the Varnashram dharma obligations. So then your karma, that's why when you begin bhakti, your karma is over. Bhakti is gunatit, karmatit, beyond this. So therefore he says that trivargika karma nivrittim dyotyante. So this is indicating that they became free or renounced or not obligated to perform trivarga actions. But if you see the whole story, after meeting Krishna, then what did Krishna tell them? Go back. So then how is that they gave up trivarga and then they're coming back to the same place? So giving up is not giving up physically, but giving up them as their shelter, their ashraya or attachment. This is also meaning when Krishna says sarvadharman parityajya. So the idea is not to give up the thing physically, but it is not that we are dependent on this dharma anymore, that if I do not do this, then I will go to hell, this is my duty, and if I do this, I will go to heaven, otherwise I am lost. So that is not the purpose. Purpose is that now he does them, but he is not attached to them, and he is not thinking that these duties are necessary for him to attain the goal of life. Now his trivarga is taken care of by bhakti. So as Krishna says, yoga kshema mahamyam. So it also does not mean that he just sits down and does nothing. So in Gita also Krishna showed that Arjuna was there before and he did not want to fight. And after understanding Bhagavad Gita, then he fought again. Otherwise he would have said, well, now there is no need for me to fight. I understood. So therefore he says, eva ardha avasitam karma vihai, that their duties which they were performing before that were not completed. So you can give up something if you have completed it. But halfway, if they are boiling milk, if they are cooking porridge or they are milking cows, they have not completed the activity, they have dropped it. And ye use tadaha duhanteti. So therefore, the verse is duhantya, while milking. Payaha sthalistham chullayam adhishitya etat kvatham apratikshamana kaschit yayi. So there was milk in a pot and she had put the pot on the oven and she did not wait for it to boil and then bring it down. Apratikshamana, not delaying it, but they left. Sanyavam godhum kananam pakvam anudvasya anuttari. And sanyava means it is godhum kana, it is wheat, which is not ground completely but broken into small pieces. That's what porridge is.
So what was that? What word?
Sanyavam.
Yeah, what was the other word?
Godhum kana annam. Oh. Godhum means wheat.
Yeah, yeah, good.
So pakvam udva anudvasya, without taking it off from the fire, they left.
But they were not forced to go back by something. Only that because this was a wish of Krishna. So this going back actually.
Force means what?
Force, like if you don't complete something, then you go back and you are forced. I mean, by karma we are forced to do things, right? No? But they don't function on the karma level. Because now they are behind, because they love Krishna so much. So then, this sending them back, what is the real meaning? Because they don't have to complete things.
So real meaning is that you have to remain where you are and be devoted. Not that you go and everybody goes and sits inside the temple room.
Nobody goes and sits inside the temple room. Nobody goes and sits inside the temple room. In their bhajan kutya.
Okay.
Everybody seems to understand the philosophy. That's why they don't go and sit.
Of course.
Okay. So let's read Brihad Vaishnav Toshni of Sanatana Goswami. Paramohana tadgitena nija deha dahikadi upeksya atma karma loka dharmadikam parityajya gata iti shloka traya varnayan tatra adu kashanchit svajati karma parityagamaha duhantya iti. So after hearing that song, which has the power to attract everybody, Paramohana tadgitena, so the gopis, they dropped their loka dharma, means their regular duties related with their body or things related to the body. Deha dehe kadi upekshaya. So not concerned, not caring for that. Atma karma loka dharma adhikam. So their own respective actions, duties, paritajya gata iti. They went to Krishna. So this is what is being described in the three shlokas, beginning from this number 5, 5, 6 and 7. So tatradavu kashanchit swajati karma pratyagamaha. So in the beginning, in the first shloka, it is described that they are giving up their duties which is related to their jati. So their birth duty or duties related according to their caste. So gopis are cowherd women, and the duty of the cowherd women is milking, taking care of the cows. So therefore that is the first thing which is described, duhantya. So duhantya adhiyayu kashchit doham hitva samatsakaha. So this is related to one's jati. Duhantyo ga doham dohanam dugdham va. So milking the cow, and doham means dohanam, milking, or doham can also means milk. So either the process of milking or the milk itself, they dropped the milk, did not keep it in a proper place. Tadanim atra gopinam api krishnartham godohane pravittah. So he says that gopis, they were engaged in milking cows for Krishna. Antarbhuta niyantam dohayante tiyat. So this duhantya can also be taken as nich pratyaya, which is in the sense of what is called causative.
Causative.
When you make someone else do something. So means
dohayante.
And if they were
telling the men to do it.
Yeah. Making someone else work for them. And they were probably standing and observing. So they left that. Duhantya can also mean duhiyantya. Duhayantya.
It would be duhanti. The regular form would be duhanti.
Yeah, but here, this is Kshatri Pratyaya. Duhantya, now it becomes Dohayantya.
Yeah.
So, Abhiyayur, Venu Gita Abhimukham Yayu. So, Yayu is the Adhatu to go. Yati Yata Yamti. And Abhi is used as a prefix to this. So, this is to indicate that they went in the direction of Krishna. That is the meaning of Abhiyaya. Krishna Abhimukhyena means keeping their face towards Krishna, which means in the direction of Krishna they went. Kashchid ityadikam bahula yutha bheda apekshaya. So here the word used is kashchit, which is in plural. So it is not kashchit or kachit, feminine will be kachit. So instead of kachit, it is kashit, which means many of them, or at least three. Right? Meaning. So he says, this means that there were many of them who were performing this kind of service or work. Why? Bahula yutha bheda pekshaya. Because there are many, many groups of the gopis. A lot of gopis. India is known for population. Not only now. From Krishna's time also, when you hear the number of people, I don't know where they were staying. So much description of the forest and so many people also. But because this is possible, because in India you have joint family system. So in one room there can be 10-15 people. The rest, you have a big house, one person. Maximum two, right? Sometimes one person, huge house. And in India, small room, there are 10 people sleeping. So that's how you see that so many people were there. Villages were very small. I lived in a village, very small villages, small, small houses. They don't make big houses. And everybody just puts their cots one next to another one.
Especially in cold. Thandi ke samay.
Yeah, and in the thand, when it is cold, you go inside, and when it is hot, you are just outside in the open. Everybody is just putting their cots outside and sleeping. There's nothing on top. And go on the roof. That's how people sleep. So in a small place, a lot of people can live. And you don't need toilet, a test bathroom, one well. Everybody goes to that. And everybody is pulling water from the well. Yeah, actually now if you think the way people are living now, you need so much land for living. Previously people lived like that. In a small hut, there are 10 people living. No. The whole world, Jagat, is there.
So what do you do with mosquitoes when you're sleeping outside?
Mosquitoes, they come and bite.
They're part of the family.
I remember my childhood. Now I think, how we were sleeping.
Yeah.
There were no mosquito net, I tell you.
Yeah, at that time.
Right? There were no mosquito net. And there was no this jali and all that. It's open.
No fan.
No fan. There was no electricity. And you just sleep like that. And there were mosquitoes. Big ones.
No malaria.
Malaria was not so much. Sometimes it was there, but I don't remember getting any malaria any time. Mm. The first time I got malaria when I was in Tirupati after joining ISKCON. Before that I never got it. So either those mosquitoes or just wanted blood and not trouble you otherwise. It's my food supply, I should not
just because that's part of the family. We take our blood and we don't give you any
mouse comes in my room. I'm making so much arrangement, but there used to be mouse, there were dogs, there were cats, mosquitoes, flies, birds, monkeys, everybody. And then, and especially if you have cows, you know how many mosquitoes come because of that?
Mm-hmm.
Every house would have animals in their pass, their cow dung and urine, and that invites a lot of mosquitoes.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody lived like that. So many living beings besides human beings. It's quite amazing how things lived. So gopis were also living like that. Don't think that gopis were living in some big palaces or anything. They're also living in huts.
Yes, the image has changed people's view. They don't think of the gopis. Well, I mean, of course, But when you think that the, you know, when the Babaji's and so on who had became Siddha and saw Lalita or Radharani coming to them, they would see, they say, actually a Vrajavasi girl as
yeah,
they are.
They were exactly like this. People don't believe now. They say, oh, this is Indian, this is that. No, no, it is actually they were like this. These gopis, they lived in villages and they were all mud houses. There are no brick houses. Now you sit down under a thing and you can imagine that they were living in palace and golden this and golden that and gems and this. There was nothing like that. Otherwise, why Krishna was hanging under a bullock cart, tell me. At least everybody agreed that there was this Shaktasura story. So if he was living in a palace, what the bullock cart was doing there? At least there would have been a chariot, minimum. There is no talk of any chariot. The first time chariot comes to Braj is when Akrura comes. There is no chariot, all bullocks and bullock carts, and that's what you hear when Govardhan Leela comes. Right? They are taking all the food in Shakat to Govardhan. They are doing parikrama, cows. It's a simple life. Not much technology needed. No complicated, everybody is living like that. So therefore he says that there are lot of groups of these gopis, vanita shata yuthapa ityagre vakshamana, hundreds of them, groups. So tattar nam nam grahanam gaurav bharat. So he is not taking their names because of respect for them, because in India it's a custom, you don't take the name of respectable people.
Gaurav bhayat.
So, kim va tesham smaran visheshatvene prem vaikalya vaikal padan bhayat. Or, he is not taking their name because just remembering them, he would become full of ecstatic symptoms of love and then not able to speak. Etaccha Sri Bhagavatamrit Puru Khande Vivritam Eva.
Advertising.
Yes. It's called cross-referencing.
Yeah.
So he is saying that I have explained this in Bhagavatamrit. Tathabhyane hetuhu samutsakaha kal vilambun saha asamartha. So why is that they ran like this? Because they were samutsaka, they were very eager. So what does that mean? That they were unable to tolerate any delay. Esha hetur agre api sarvatra anuvarte. He said this reasoning should be applied in the upcoming verses also. That why were they behaving like this? Because of samutsakaha, means being very, very eager. And thus intolerant of any time delay. Because when you are so eager to do something, same example probably is of hunger, when you are hungry and you are really very hungry, at that time you don't want to watch TV or let me do this, let me, you just want to eat, drop everything and just grab the food, so like that. So they were hungry exactly like that, or even more intense. Aparayatyasya purvena parena pi anuva. So, where is apara? Okay, there is a word apara, aparayayu. So he says that this apara has to be applied before and also in the upcoming verses, both places. Evam agrepi. So similar explanation has to be applied in this way, which means that there are certain words which you have to carry over from one part of the verse to the second part, third part, maybe even to the next verse also, because there is no need of repeating that. So these words, for example, hitva, giving up, it has to be applied everywhere. Similarly, the word apara has to be applied. Anyatyair vyakhyatam. The rest has been explained by Sridhar Swami. यद्वा पयश्चुल्यामधिश्रित्य अनुद्वाश्य पक्वमपि ततो नौत्तार्य संयावं चाधिश्रित्य अनुवादि. सो श्रीधर स्वामी हैज सेड दैट ही मेड टू सेपरेट डिविजन्स दैट समवन हैड पुट मिल्क फॉर बॉइलिंग एंड समवन हैज पुट पॉरिज फॉर कुकिंग. सो ही सेज और इट जस्ट रेफर्स टू वन थिंग ओनली. अधिश्रित्य मीन्स पुटिंग इट अप. And anuvasya means not putting it down. It's talking about the same thing. This can also be the meaning. That's how he says, payas chulyam adhishritya, putting the milk on the oven, anuvasya pakkam api, and not taking it out, although it was cooked, tato no tarya, did not take it down, sanyavam cha adhishritya anuvasya. And similarly, the porridge also. So he's applying that both milk and porridge, putting it up. Adhishritya means putting on fire. Anudvasya means taking it down. So it is applying for milk, putting it up, and then not taking it down. And also for porridge, putting it up and not taking it down. This was another thing. So this is on verse number 5. And we'll stop here.
I feel sad that it stopped.
Okay. Any question? Clear?
Very clear.
Okay. Anybody else has anything to say? Yes.
So the gopis were doing one specific seva. And then...
At that time.
Yes, at that time.
Yeah.
And then they heard the flute and then they gave it up.
Yes.
So... But they were doing the seva for him. Why did they give it up? Does it just mean that when he calls for something else, then you just give it up and then do something else? Or...
Well, that is what you are thinking, that they're doing it for him. But he is explaining it in a different manner. Mm-hmm. He's saying that they were not doing it for him, they were doing it as their regular duty.
Ah, okay, yeah.
And they give it up to meet Krishna. And then they come back and do it, and now they will do it for him. So that is the process of bhakti.
I was wondering about this going so fast that not, they could not even notice it.
Yes.
So, I mean, if you are serving somebody and then suddenly you disappear so fast, I mean, what is the...
Yeah, this is just to show the eagerness.
The eagerness.
That how they were so, what you call, transfixed.
So they didn't consider anything.
That when your mind is fixed like that, then you do nothing. Just take example of hunger. I think that is the most practical one. These days, love examples also don't work. You don't have that kind of love these days. Obviously, you could give an example of love. Now, I think hunger is a good example. It still works. Now, love is just a talk. Okay.